Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today I want to share my bi-monthly favorites. So what are the products that I've been really enjoying in the last 2 months? And I'm going to start off with complexion. First up is the NARS Tinted Moisturizer. I bought it. I tried 2 samples of this baby and it's just such a beautiful product. It is a moisturizer, it has a tint, and that tint has actually pretty decent coverage. So quite surprised that it's not a super sheer coverage. You can kind of build it up to maybe light plus. So I really enjoyed that. I love the fact that it's a moisturizer. I do find it hydrating for my skin. I love how it looks when it sets on the skin. It's like slightly hydrated, but also it sets down slightly soft matte. It's quite an interesting formulation. I loved how this looked on me. So of course I purchased this product, and I'm really happy to say that I've really been torn between this MAC Face and Body and the Ilia Skin Tint. I really love all 3 products. It was a very hard decision which one should I buy. I only wanted to buy one just because I mainly use foundations, and skin tints are the type of products that I will use now and then. So if I'm just gonna go run some errands or anything like that, that's when really I would use a skin tint. If I want to go out or if I'm going to work, I'll actually use a foundation, which is the only reason why I did not buy the MAC Face and Body and the Ilia. Otherwise I would have, because all 3 were beautiful, but I settled on this one. Now my shade is Saint Moritz, which is just a little bit light for me as of right now because I'm slightly tan at the moment. Not too tan, but just a little bit. I can still make it work though, so I can still wear this even though I'm slightly tan. So I'm okay with that. Anyway, beautiful product. I have done a whole video on this, so if you haven't seen that, check that out. Next up, I also purchased the Huda Beauty Luminous Matte Foundation. So I have been oohing and eyeing about this foundation since I reviewed it. So for those of you who may be new to my channel, I generally get samples, test it out, do a review, and then I think about buying them or not. So this foundation has a lot of pros. No fragrance, no alcohol. It did not break me out. That's a big thing. Same with the NARS. The NARS does have fragrance, but it did not break me out, and that is so important for my skin. I feel like a lot of complexion products that try out end up breaking me out, which is really sad. So definitely didn't break me out. I love that it has super full coverage. I mean, you can really build this up. So I love wearing it on days when my skin isn't really feeling that well, or I have a lot of spots that I want to cover, anything like that. I really gravitate towards the Huda Beauty because it really covers while also making your skin look natural. Like, I've tried full coverage foundations before and they always kind of look so full coverage and so almost heavy on the skin. What I love about this product, that although it's quite thick in texture, it doesn't look heavy on the skin. It is actually a beautifully skin-like foundation while also being thick and providing full coverage. I don't know how it works. It just works. Now, I have done a full review on this, so please check out all the details in that review if you're interested in this foundation, because I go into a lot of detail in those reviews. So I won't mention all of those details here. Otherwise, this video would be like an hour. I do want to mention the downside with this product is the initial application, because it is a little bit thick. It can be a little bit difficult to blend. And what I've been actually doing lately is I would pump a little bit of this out. Just on my fingers, got a nice pump, so you can really control how much you're pumping. And then I'll just apply like a little bit on my cheek and then just blend it out straight away. And then I'll move to this side, cover this area, and then cover my forehead. So working in sections really is amazing with this product. I can blend it out easily. It doesn't dry out on me. It doesn't tug the skin or anything like that. Also, make sure you have a nice hydrating base underneath. Beautiful, beautiful foundation. Very happy that I have it. I have the shade 320G, which is also a good color match for me. Especially right now when I'm a little bit tan, this color match is spot on and perfect. Next up, my Holy Grail foundation, the one I cannot stop wearing at all. And I think if you're someone who often looks at my descriptions to see what makeup I'm wearing, you will see this foundation time and time again, pretty much since I got it last year. is the Dior Forever Skin Glow Foundation. It is currently what I have on at the moment. I love the beautiful, dewy, natural finish that this foundation gives. The color match is a really good color match for me. 3 warm olive. By the way, if you find that I'm blinking a lot, please ignore that. My eyes are feeling really tired and slightly strained at the moment. I feel like I need some eye drops. So I'm kind of blinking at these lights going, normally this doesn't bother me, but today is not that day. It does have alcohol and it does have fragrance. Fragrance doesn't really bother me. Can't really smell it by now. I think I'm just too used to it. The alcohol actually also doesn't seem to irritate my skin at all because I've been using this consistently for a year. So it hasn't broken me out. It hasn't given me any irritation whatsoever. So although it does have alcohol in this formulation, I haven't found this to be problematic. Truly a holy grail status foundation for me. By the way, if my under eyes look really heavy today, and that's just because I didn't sleep well, so I'm actually really tired. I probably shouldn't have been filming this video tonight, but oh well, I wanted to get this video out as quickly as possible because I have so many to do, and I'm just trying to be a little bit time efficient at the moment. Let's move on to the next product. So I also purchased the NARS corrector in the shade medium. Now I have done a review for this product, so check it out if you want to get all the details, how it applies, that type of thing. Medium is a perfect shade for my under eye circles. It's nice and creamy, but it does set down, so when you apply your concealer on top, you know, your concealer isn't moving around or anything like that. So I did try a sample of this, really loved it, so now I purchased the full size. Another purchase, well, this is actually a repurchase. I really loved the Huda Beauty mascara. When I finished this, I was kind of sad. And so I have now repurchased a brand new tube of the Huda Beauty mascara. Love it. If you're looking for a mascara that's going to give you really huge lashes, I think this is amazing. It can flake a little bit sometimes, especially if you pop on quite a few layers. But like, the flaking isn't really bad, so I don't think it's really that problematic. Another mascara I really love is the Essence mascara, which is, and I feel like I'm almost out of this one, so I will absolutely be repurchasing this one. So I'll just bring it close so you can see. So this is the False Lash Effect. Really love this as well. Now, I did a video on my Too Faced concealers. I got a lot of sample pots to try out and I ended up picking 2 shades. I got a full size of Warm Beige, and Warm Beige is what I'm wearing at the moment. It's a very natural looking concealer for me. As you can see, it doesn't look bright or anything like that under my eyes. However, I do like a brightening concealer, so I also picked up a travel size of Natural Beige, which gives me a very nice brightening effect under the eyes. If you watched my NARS Climax palette review video, I'm wearing the Natural Beige in that video. I've also really enjoyed the Dior Skin Correct Concealer. I held off buying on this for the longest time because it was so expensive, but I think it was worth the purchase for sure. I love how smoothing it is. It lasts all day. It does crease a little bit, like majority of concealers crease. And I just love how smooth it looks under the eyes. So a huge fan of this concealer. I have done a video on it, if you're curious. I also want to mention the Sephora powder. So this is a recommendation from one of you, and it's amazing. I haven't tried this powder before, and this is a beautiful powder from Sephora. This is actually their powder foundation. And I use it for setting my face as well as a powder foundation. So for example, on days that I don't really want to do anything, like I don't even want to wear this, what I would do is pop on my sunscreen and then I'll pop this all over my face and it looks beautiful. It gives me a very natural finish while still giving me a little bit of coverage, and it mattifies my skin so that I don't look super oily, especially with that sunscreen. So I've enjoyed it wearing it that way. I've also enjoyed it just as a setting powder. And actually, I might pop some on now because I'm looking a little bit shiny. And I've really been enjoying this as a setting powder. You really don't need a lot because it is a powder foundation after all. So it definitely has coverage. That's how much I've picked up. And I'm just going to tap that right here. And this really does remind me of the Kosas powder. The powder isn't drying. It has really good coverage. I mean, you saw that. That looks amazing. And I'm gonna pop that right here. It's a little bit more mattifying than your Kosas powder. So I feel like one of you, hey Deepthi, if you're watching, Deepthi mentioned this might be a dupe for Kosas. And I think she might be right, because this might actually be a dupe for Kosas. It is quite similar. It's a creamy powder. It doesn't look cakey or heavy or dry on the skin. It applies beautifully. However, it does give you more coverage and it does mattify a little bit more than Kosas. So this might be an amazing option for people who are concerned about some oil. Throughout the day, as my oils start to come through, I will blot my face, and then I will still see coverage after blotting. I feel like the powder doesn't disappear. Yes, your oils come through, but when you blot, that powder application that you applied in the morning is still there. So you still have that coverage. That's amazing. And I think that's probably just because this is a powder foundation after all. So it is supposed to stay on the skin. So I've really been enjoying this. Huge favorite. So highlighters under my foundation. My running favorite is still the Charlotte Tilbury. You guys already know this is a holy grail product for me. Shade 5 is my absolute favorite. Now, I have also really been enjoying the M Cosmetics Cushion Highlighter, and it works so well for my skin tone. And I've really been loving this underneath foundation, but also on top of foundation. This formulation does not screw up with my cream products or my powder products. I can tap it on the skin. It doesn't really budge or move. And I love that. I mean, that's really gorgeous. Just look at that shine. Oh, wow. Gorgeous. So I have seriously been enjoying both of these, and I feel like I've been wearing both of them quite a bit. I always tend to wear a liquid highlighter underneath my foundation, and those two have been my go-to so far. As we're on the topic of highlighters, I also want to mention the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Star Highlighter. So this is not a new product, but it just gives such a beautiful, almost wet looking shine that is kind of hard to get from a powder. And I am in love with this powder highlighter. So I've got it right here. I mean, you can see that straight away. How gorgeous is this? It just gives you this glistening shine. Oh my God. This is a recommendation from one of you, and it has become one of my top favorite highlighters. Hands down, I cannot get over this texture. It is a little bit warm for me. Like, you can see that on my hand. It's a little bit dark, a little bit warm for me. But if I just apply a light layer, that's all you need. It works beautifully. And I know that in summer, this is going to look even better when I have tan skin. Now, let's just quickly talk about some blushes. So first up, M Cosmetics Serum Blushes. I am in love with this shade called Peachy Peach. I cannot stop wearing it. I'm in fact wearing it today. So right here that you can see, it's this blush, and it is incredibly beautiful and dewy. Oh my God. I have done a whole video on this. So if you're interested in seeing swatches of some of the other shades that I picked up, as well as tips on application or anything like that, please watch that video. I do go over quite a bit with this formula. I really love this formula. Now, this is a product that I don't think everybody is going to like, because it's very dewy. And if you have textured skin, you may not like that, because it will end up enhancing texture. You can kind of mitigate that by adding a layer of powder underneath and then applying this right on top. And just a sheer amount, it will look beautiful and dewy, and that powder will just help to make sure that texture doesn't show up quite a bit. So this is that shade that I'm wearing right now. Absolutely stunning. Cannot get enough of this specific color, but these blushes are beautiful. I also want to mention the Salt New York. So I've been wearing these, and first of all, I love this palette. This palette is gorgeous. So that's what this palette looks like. When you select this palette from the website, you can go ahead and choose your singles. These are the singles that I picked up. I picked up a medium bronzer. I'll put the shades in the description box because I've forgotten them now. But how stunning is this beautiful palette? So these cream blushes blend and apply effortlessly. it just, they're so easy. So, so easy. Now, it is winter here in New Zealand, so they have kind of dried down, which means I'm gonna have to warm them up with my finger to pick up a product. But then they warm up, because in cold weather, they will kind of harden. However, when you warm it up in your finger, oh, you can see that, the product comes out beautiful. So if you have this product and you are in a cold climate, don't worry, that's just how they are. And you just need to give it a little bit of a rub and they will be just fine. So these are the two blushes that I picked up. Absolutely stunning, pigmented, but still sheer enough that you're not going to have trouble in terms of application. So these are the two blush shades that I picked up. The highlighter is incredibly beautiful. The cream bronzer is stunning. It's got the nice yellow undertone. I'm just going to swatch the bronzer for you as well. So that's the highlighter there, and that's the bronzer. Now I did get the highlighter that's a little bit too warm. I do need to pick up from them one shade down for the highlighter because it's just a little bit too warm for me right now. Gorgeous products. Now, they do stay on all day. They will fade after 7 hours a little bit, but you know, by the time I come home, it's been eight and a half hours, the product is still on my cheek. Yes, it's faded a little bit, but it's still there. And you saw it, it's beautifully creamy and pigmented and easy to blend. Amazing cream blush formula, and they aren't hugely expensive either. So check them out. The brand also often does sales, so you can kind of get 20, even 30% off. Actually, if you get a palette with the four, you get 30% off the entire order, so that's great. I've also been really loving the Natasha Denona Love Cheek Duo. First of all, this is a fabulous blush. It sets down, it really smooths out, so your skin looks super smooth. And the color is epic. It's just, it is such a beautiful formulation from Natasha Denona. I really want to see if other shades exist in this because it's too pretty. So this shade is the blush. It is stunning. I've also actually enjoyed the highlighter. Now the highlighter isn't my favorite because it's a little bit too sparkly. That's the highlighter there. But the color alone is perfection. I cannot get over this pinky gold. It's such a beautiful highlighter. Oh my god, these two pair so well together. So I have actually been wearing this highlighter, and what I've been doing is I will kind of dig my finger in there, so I smooth out the product with my finger, then I smooth it out on the back of my hand, tap a little bit, get some of those sparkles off, and then pat it into the skin. Whew, gorgeous, gorgeous highlighter, amazing. I just wish the sparkle had been a little bit finer, but other than that, it's beautiful and it looks really great on my skin tone. That's another thing. I also have a video on this, by the way. Most of these products that I'm talking about, I have a fully fledged review video on them, so if you want to know details about any of them, please go check it out. I also want to quickly mention the Rare Beauty blushes. I've really been enjoying two specific shades. The Grace shade, which if you've seen my Rare Beauty video, I think you've seen how much I rave about this shade. The shade Grace is really like this perfect mauve tone for my skin. It looks incredibly flattering. And I'm obsessed more so with the color than with the formulation. And I could not find any other cream formulation with this exact same shade. The other shade I've been loving is Joy. So this is Joy and this is Grace. Joy is a dewy finish and this one is a matte finish. Been enjoying both of these colors so much. Again, I have a whole video on this. So that's it for the cream blushes. Now let's talk about some bronzers. Huda Beauty Glowish Bronzer, hands down, an epic find this year. I adore this formulation, and yes, I'm gonna be buying her new blushes. I'm pretty sure they are this formulation, and I love it. I've got the shade Deep Tan, which is a really good bronzing shade for me, so look at that. It's not too warm, but just warm enough, has more of that caramel undertone. I love how smooth and slightly creamy they are. They have almost like a skin-like finish, so I'm wearing it today, and it just looks so beautiful. It's creamy, but it's not sticky. It's also lightweight. It's a little bit smoothing and it's skin-like. It perfection. So I cannot wait to get the blushes in this formula. Next up, I've tried a lot of cream bronzers this year, and out of all the ones that I have, there's really only two specific cream bronzers that I've been reaching for all the time. Pretty much every time I do my makeup, I end up reaching for these. First up is the Milk Makeup Bronzer. This is in the shade Baked. It has this really lightweight, creamy, and almost a little bit dewy application. And it blends so effortlessly, you guys. And the shade is perfection for my skin tone. Everything about this bronzer, I love. From longevity to blending, application, how it looks, the shade, everything. So this is the shade right here. Gorgeous. As you can see, it's a little bit lighter than the Huda bronzer, but similar tones. These are the type of tones that look tend to look good on me. Next up that I've been really enjoying is the cream bronzer from ABH. Cannot put this down, especially the shade Amber. Amber is such a unique shade. I'm not sure if I've come across a shade like this yet. It's really flattering on my skin tone, and this formulation is thick. It's like a thick cream, and it blends so easily, lasts all day. My hair doesn't stick to it. Check out that tone. I mean, you can see it almost has a little bit of a olive undertone, I feel like. And that's probably why I love it so much, because I have a slight olive undertone, and with this shade, it's super flattering. So very much have enjoyed this formulation. I enjoyed this formula so much, I even ended up getting the shade Caramel because it's just so beautiful. So those were my favorites in the bronzers. I also have the Chanel bronzer, which is very good, but I don't know, there's just something about these two. The formulation, the blendability, the shades, that I just end up reaching for these two every time. So let's quickly talk about eyes. I don't have too many products to show you with eyes, but I do want to share with you my favorites in the last couple of months. Ellis Faas cream eyeshadows. Wow. I did a look with these when I did the date night tutorial, the date night makeup tutorial. So if you want to see these in action, check out that makeup tutorial, because I used a brown and a black to create that smoky eye, and it's such a beautiful product. So the shade that I'm wearing on my eyes today is this cream eyeshadow. I'm wearing the shade E127. It has this beautiful, warm, almost rustic undertone. Oh my God. I love it. Perfect for fall. A gorgeous color. You don't need anything else with it. Like, this is a one and done eyeshadow. You really don't need anything else. This also isn't matte. It's a satin finish. So I think even mature eyelids will really enjoy this formula. So right at the top right here, this beautiful shade is E127, which is what I've currently got all over my eye. Then at the bottom, which is that beautiful dark brown, it's E126. And then the black shade is E103. And you can see how incredibly pigmented these cream eyeshadows are. Extremely pigmented and yet very blendable. They also have a really good playing time. So if you wanted to take your time to blend out these eyeshadows, you don't have to rush and worry that they're going to set on you. They are just very, I think, very beginner friendly. Love, love, love these. I have already placed an order for more shades because totally worth the money. I mean, they are expensive. You're spending quite a lot to buy a single cream eyeshadow, but in my opinion, they're just worth every cent. Next up, I've really been enjoying the Desert Monsoon palette. This is from the brand What's Up Beauty. So this is an indie brand from the US, and they sent me this product to try out, and I was pleasantly surprised with this palette. First of all these eyeshadows are in fact made in Italy, and it was really funny because when I started playing around with these matte shades, I was so amazed at how good quality the mattes were that I straight away looked at the back of the palette thinking, wait, are these mattes made in Italy? No way. Yeah, they are. So the palette itself is assembled in the USA, but the eyeshadows are in fact made in Italy, and you can kind of tell that just from the mattes. The mattes are amazing quality. It's almost very similar to the Patrick Ta matte eyeshadows, that they're very blendable and very soft. Now, there is a difference between that formulation and this formulation. These are in fact more pigmented than the Patrick Ta eyeshadows, so I kind of like these better. There's also better smoke out shades in this palette because you do get these really deep tones. I mean, look at these two shades. These are beautiful and gorgeous smoke out shades, particularly for brown skin. You get this very beautiful reddish brown, and then you get this almost charcoal brown. It's like a very cool tone, almost black and brown. Beautiful. Oh my god, these swatch very nicely. So this is how they've swatched. Very pigmented, easy to build, and I was able to kind of layer them in several layers. They didn't give me any issues. Even the pink, I've enjoyed wearing. There's a pink matte eyeshadow in here. Oh my god, it looks, let me look at that. That's the pink eyeshadow. It looks really good on my skin tone. So that is the pink right there. Stunning. So I've really enjoyed the mattes. I think the mattes are spectacular in this palette. They also are not the type of mattes that will blend out into nothing. So I think that was one of the characteristics of the Patrick Ta matte eyeshadows, is that they kind of just disappeared and would blend into nothing, which can be good for beginners, but not so good if you're so used to doing your makeup, because you don't want your blending to just disappear. You know, you still want to softly blend, but you still want that pigment there. So what I find with these is that, yes, they're a soft formula, you can blend them easily, but they don't disappear. In terms of longevity, I do find that the mattes will perform better on top of an eye primer. Without an eye primer, you can see a little bit of creasing by the end of the day. And then let's talk about the shimmer formula. My favorite formula in this palette is this blue right here. This is absolutely divine. So I did a look with this blue eyeshadow and I got so many compliments. People just loved it because it's so vibrant and yet deep enough for brown skin tones. Whew, let me swatch it for you. The interesting thing with this formula, so I'm going to pop my finger in, is when I swipe my finger in there, I can feel that it has a little bit of a moisture content. It's quite interesting. It is a flaky shade, like it's slightly flaky, but when you swipe it, it just glides so easily because of that slightly high moisture content, and it looks beautiful. So I'm just gonna, oh my god, that is stunning. So that is the blue eyeshadow right there. I love it. I really, really love it. And then when you press your finger in and you kind of just smooth it out, the flakes just melt away. And then you just get this beautiful, shiny pigment. This is a duochrome, so it's like a royal blue color with purple reflex. My favorite shade in this palette. I don't think I will ever get rid of this palette just because of this shade. Now, the other shimmers are nice in my opinion, but I don't think they can compete with this formulation. This formulation is too good. And I feel like next time What's a Beauty do a palette, they really need to include more of this one. Because this is my standout formulation in this palette. The only shade I don't like is the green. I feel like the green is quite flat on my skin tone. So I don't particularly enjoy this green eyeshadow. But everything else I can use, and I've definitely enjoyed it. And lastly, I want to talk about some lip products. Bite Beauty Lipsticks. Such a great lipstick formulation. Oh my god, I have loved these. And the shades that I've been reaching for quite a bit are Tamarind. So I'm just going to swatch them at the back of my hand. Tamarind, which is a beautiful peach shade, and it looks amazing on my skin tone. Then we've got this shade right here, which is Sugar Buns, and then Harissa. These are really the three shades I feel like I've been kind of gravitating towards in the last couple of months. Very much enjoyed this formulation. And then we've got Gucci lipsticks. Also cannot get enough of this formula. It's just so matte and pigmented, and it wears really well throughout the day. The two shades I've been reaching for quite a bit are Peggy Taupe and Janet Rust. Okay, so this is the shade Peggy Taupe, like a perfect pinky nude. And then Janet Rust, oh my god, Janet Rust is just everything. So those have been my two running favorites from Gucci. And I also want to mention Rare Beauty Lip Soufflés. I've been really enjoying these lip matte lip creams from Rare Beauty. And I also have two favorites from the Rare Beauty. I've got here, which is the shade Fearless, and here the shade Transform. Gorgeous colors. I have done a whole video on it. So if you want to see how all of these shades look like on my lips, please check out those very specific lip swatch videos. I think the only products I may not have a video on might just be these two. I think these two might be the only two products that I don't actually have a video on. Otherwise, I have kind of videos on everything else. So for more details, check out those specific videos. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and please let me know what have been your favorites for the last 2 months. I would absolutely love to hear some of your recommendations, and I'll see you guys in my next video. See ya.